Good morning, friends, and here we are back with another lecture. And the topic this time is social accounting. Now, why I opted this topic of social accounting is because this topic is of high relevance these days. Why? Because business or any industry is a kind of socio-economic activity and it draws its input from the society. Hence, its objective should be of the welfare of the society also. It should owe a responsibility towards solving many of the social problems as well. And if we see that today, with the changing environments and social parameters, situation have compelled the business enterprises to account and report information with regard to discharge of their social responsibilities. So that is how we opted this topic this time, which is social accounting, and let's understand a bit about this. So this will be an introductory chapter. Let's move ahead. There are a few names, other names also of social accounting. These are social accounting and auditing, social accountability, social and environmental accounting, corporate social reporting, corporate social responsibility reporting, and non-financial reporting or accounting. So now, what is social accounting? It's a process of communicating the social and environmental effects of an organization, its economic actions to particular interest groups within a society, or we can say that to the whole society at large. This social accounting is different from public interest accounting as well as from critical accounting. So this is a kind of communicating the impact of an organization, especially organization's economic actions, over the society as a whole. This is the simplest definition of social accounting. Now, to go into the scope of social accounting, a few are enlisted here. Basically, social accounting is used in business in the context of corporate social responsibility. These days, this CSR or the corporate social responsibility has become a mandate for almost every kind of organization, where they have to devote some certain part of their business or their work or finance and for the welfare of society. So this social accounting is used there. Then it is used in kind of organizations including NGOs, the charities and other government agencies for the same purpose. Also, it can be used in conjunction with community-based monitoring, that how all these activities add up to assessing the effect of organization's economic activity over the society at a large and communicating it further. Now, in the words of Mr. D. Crowther, if we define social accounting, then he defines social accounting as an approach to reporting a firm's activities which stresses the need for the identification of social relevant behavior, the determination of those to whom the company is accountable for its performance, and development of appropriate measures and reporting technique. So in his words, he defined that it's a kind of a tool that helps any organization to appropriately monitor its activity and communicating it further, that what can be the effect or of those economic activities over the societies at large. It is an important step in helping companies independently develop their CSR programs, which are shown to be much more effective than government mandate CSR. So that is how social accounting is very important, because it can help every organization to develop their own CSR program for the welfare of society, adding up to the a few mandatory norms being made by the government. So that is going to ultimately help into the welfare of the society. Now let us see a few facts about social accounting. It is a broad field that can be divided into narrower fields, meaning to say that it can be divided into three main other fields. The first is environmental accounting, the second is sustainability accounting, and the third is national accounting. So just have a quick look over, just understand it quickly, what is an environmental accounting. It may account for an organization's impact on the natural environment. So this part assesses the impact of economic activity over the natural environment. The second is social accounting, the sustainability accounting, which is the quantitative analysis of social and economic sustainability. As we all know, sustainability mainly deals with the sustenance of the resources for our future generation. So it talks about the equal, justified and efficient division of the resources within limits so that we can sustain something for our future generation also. And national accounting uses economics as a whole as the method of its analysis. Some of the main tools used in social accounting are enlisted below. There are social audit, public hearing, citizen scorecards, public expenditure tracking survey, which is PETS, use of citizens charter, use of complaint box. All these are the tools to assess the impact of economic activity of the organization, different organization or the industrial fraternity over the society. So these are the tools that are mainly used in social accounting to assess and communicate that impact. Now if we talk about the relationship or the interdependence between the International Standard Organization, which is ISO, and the social accounting, then the International Standard Organization ISO provided a standard ISO 26000, which is a resource for social accounting, and it addresses these seven core areas that are being listed here: the organizational governance, human rights, labor practices, environment, fair operating practices, consumer issues, and community involvement and development. These seven core areas are used to assess the social responsibility accounting by the organizations. And for this ISO provided this standard ISO 26000 framework. Now, why do we need social accounting? Why the society needs social accounting? Why? Because social accounting challenges the conventional accounting, in particular the financial accounting, for giving a narrow image of the interaction between society and organization, and thus artificially constraining the subject of accounting, and it provides a much broader scope and area of application to the field of accounting. So that is why we need social accounting, because it broadened the scope of the field of accounting, because it is not only particularly constrained till the area of financial accounting. It talked much in detail, like we studied earlier, that they are divided into major three fields, which all deals with the several aspects of the interdependence of an organization and the society as a whole. So it gave the accounting part a much more broader view of the interaction of the society and the organization. So this is the conclusion part. Social accounting thus is a very helpful and effective tool, because it seeks to broaden the scope of accounting. First of all, it concerns itself with more than only economic events. It is not exclusively expressed in financial terms. It is accountable to a broader group of stakeholders. It broadened its purpose beyond reporting financial success, and it helps the company monitor their social performance in a much better and realistic manner. So that is how social accounting is very important for us, and it helps the society as well as the organization as a whole, and it also helps the government to understand the forthcoming or the unforeseen impact of the regular organizational activities going on around over the society at large. So this was the lecture 17 about the social accounting. Keep watching our, or you can subscribe to my channel for more of such relevant lectures, and you can press the bell icon so that you get notified of the upcoming lecture. Thank you for watching, and I wish you lot of luck for your studies and your career. Thank you very much.